Shannon, should the Chiefs be allowed to do this?
They shouldn't even have to. Skip. In broad NFL contracts, they says you are not to partake in anything where there's a reasonable risk. Skip, the Chiefs have a bag. All Patrick Mahomes has to do is not fumble it. After next year, Skip, they're probably going to have $150, $175 million on the table. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't understand the upside. Patrick, we understand you were probably a four-star recruit. Star. Great at football, obviously. Baseball, because your dad played great, tremendous arm. Basketball. Okay, I get all of that. What's the upside of him playing this, Skip? Do you think the Lakers are going to call and say, Patrick, we saw what you did, bro. Come on out here with us. Golden State. What's the upside? There is way, way more risk than reward in this situation. We just saw football is a dangerous game. Skip, we saw Jimmy Garoppolo stepping out of bounds. Mm-hmm. Non-contact. Boom. Patrick, because you know how we are, Skip. We're athletes. We're competitive. You're not finna get the best of me. I'm going to have to start jumping a little higher. I'm going to have to start really stopping and starting. Mm-hmm. And then boom, Achilles. Boom, ACL. Mm-hmm. I don't even know why the Chief would even have to intervene. I don't even know why Patrick Mahomes. 4 days ago, 5 days ago, you were named NFL MVP. And the reward you give yourself is not go to Cancun, not go to Turks and Caicos at the Gansevoort. You're going to go to a local gym and play pickup basketball. Mm. I want to know the good thing that could happen by him doing this, Skip Bayless. I want someone that can convince me. Say, oh, man, Patrick Mahomes, man. You seen him out there? Yeah, I saw him. I've had too many teammates also do this very same thing, Skip. Wasn't half the player that he was. Career ended.
Yeah.
ACL rupture. Mm-hmm. Achilles rupture. Mm-hmm. Why? I don't even know. And I get it, Skip. It's not specifically written in his contract that he can't play. But I don't even know why you would. Mm-hmm. I don't even know why you would risk $150, $200 million playing pickup basketball. Mm-hmm. That's the whole thing, Skip. When you become a celebrity, be it entertained or whatever you do, when you become an athlete, you got to make sacrifices, Skip, because all the things that I would normally do, mm-hmm. I'm not willing to risk those. Mm-hmm. Go skiing. You didn't go skiing for what? Mm-hmm. I'm not Peekaboo Street. Mm-hmm. I'm not Phil Mayer. You know, Skip, they were great. I'm not Franz Klammer. Mm. I'm not none of those guys. Mm. I'm a football player, and I play football. Mm. If you're a classic pianist, the last thing I think you're going to be doing is carving anything. Mm. I'm not messing up my fingers. I'm not cooking. I'm not having a habit of wood carving. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing anything that's going to jeopardize my money. Mm. Patrick Mahomes, you smarter than this. Mm-hmm. I know it.
Mm. Which is why I cannot believe the standard NFL contract doesn't stipulate in detail every one of these dangerous activities, from skydiving to bungee jumping to motorcycle riding to snow skiing. I don't have one friend who snow skis regularly who has not been hurt snow skiing. Mm-hmm. It's why I just say no, because I like to run. I still like to play basketball, and I don't want to go out there and tear up my knees on the slope. I don't get that.
No.
It's just too dangerous.
Dangerous.
And in this case, I go back to my days covering the Cowboys in the 80s. Do you realize that the 1985 Chicago Bears, that team, that was a super team. You arguably is the greatest defense ever.
Yep.
Do you realize through that offense, that offseason, that the Cowboys, who were pretty good, then they got run over by Eric Dickerson's team in the playoffs. But they were pretty good. They went on a tour, a basketball team tour, against the 85 Bears. And they would play against the Bears in high schools and various places. They played over. I covered a game one night in Fort Worth at the Civic Center. It was a huge
deal. Even in the 90s.
Yeah.
In the offseason. Okay. Teams would accumulate their best basketball players.
Right.
And they would go play.
Okay. And it was team versus team. It was professional athlete against professional athlete. In the game I covered one night in Fort Worth, they went at it, and it went to the buzzer, and the backup quarterback, Mike Tomczak, hit a shot at the buzzer, but they were killing each other.
Yeah. Yeah.
They were going at it.
Right.
Otis Wilson is bouncing people off. You know, it got very physical and, to me, very dangerous. And you know and I know there's a long list of athletes from other sports who have gotten hurt playing basketball. So the shock to me was that the video, to your point, it was a pickup basketball game with just a bunch of goofs to me. Right. I don't know unless he knows, unless they're friends of his. Mm-hmm. I don't think that they look like
And look at the friends. Hard plant, Skip.
Huh?
You remember when he got to the basket?
Yeah.
The hard plant that he didn't watch. Look at this.
Terrible.
Watch what he, look.
I mean, there's just guys.
Come on, man.
Come on. It is so dangerous. So on my little level, I still play a lot of basketball. But you know what I insist on? Always one-on-one against somebody I trust. Ernestine's always saying, hey, I met this
kid. Mm.
I don't yeah, that.
Run all day.
Mm. We're not worried about
well,
that.
What'd you do for cardio?
Rode the bike an hour before practice, mm-hmm. ran all day, did, doing practice.
No, I mean in the off-season. Off-season.
Oh, I hit that track.
Okay.
I hit that track. Yeah.
That's what they should be doing. I agree with that.
Yeah, well, that's
picking them up, putting them down.
Obviously, not as exciting as playing pickup basketball. Yeah. Which at first glance, I didn't see the problem. But you guys have convinced me. Mm. It's completely pointless to be playing in this game.
Hey, if you tear your Achilles tendon, what's it worth? Because if you tear your Achilles, you'll never be quite the same.
Nope.
Is that what you want?
Dan Marino.
Really?
Dan Marino tore his in the game.
Yeah, I know.
And he was still a great quarterback, but he wasn't that Dan.
No.
And the dude just won the MVP at 23.
Aren't a lot of people picking him to win it all next year?
Yeah, Vegas say they're the favorite.
Aren't they the favorite? Yeah, okay.
No, sir. No, sir. We. No, sir. We. I mean, come on. Hold on. Pavarotti, one of the greatest opera singer ever.
Yeah.
You think he went whistling or yodeling?
Hmm.
What'd he do? All you got to do is just don't fumble it. The bag, the bag's secure.
Mm.
Just
Roger that.
Why don't you call him and you guys can run sprints? Mm. Just do some track work.
Nah, I ain't running.
No,
Knee done got bad. Old me. Now, we going to get on that bike or we get on the roll machine or the assault bike, Skip.
Mm.
But
he can come run with me.
No.
There you go.
Yeah. Hey, on that bike, they call me Matt Frazier. I'm Matt Frazier on that bike.
No more for me.
That's silly stuff.
This next topic, interesting, because we're talking about Kyler Murray and the idea that he may actually play both football and baseball. I didn't even think about the correlation here, but we're going to discuss all that with Rob Parker next.